So I'm very happy to see so many of you here. But apart from being happy, you know, I'm also very sad. And the reason I'm sad is that we've had so many rallies of this kind over the years from the time I was a graduate student, again and again and again, and the management never seems to learn, and they seem to want to keep attacking workers and keep attacking workers, and we have to have these rallies every time to stop them. And for that reason, I'm sad, even though I see so many of my good friends here. But I think it's useful for me to recount for some of you who were perhaps not here, you know, earlier when I started my career here as a graduate student in 2004, when the first wave of layoffs happened. At that time, the endowment was set, you know, about $20 billion. And that was considered a very big thing, and there was certainly no shortage of funds. They had a lot of money. They were pouring billions of dollars into the Alston campus. But at the same time, they started a ferocious, you know, wave of cuts and attacks on the Harvard Union of Clerical and Technical Workers, including the library staff. And there was no justification with budget cuts. But, you know, there were some reasons, various reasons about library organization. And then 5 years later, after I had graduated in 2009, they started another wave of cuts. And this time they said that, you know, there was a problem because they'd lost money in the endowment and they didn't have enough money, and so they had to lay off workers. And now in 2012, the endowment is now $30 billion. You know, in 2004 it was $20 billion, and that was supposed to be a huge number. Now it's become $30 billion, but this is still not enough for Harvard to support its workers. And I think that is a real shame. And I think it's really shameful that we see that the same policies, you know, the same policies every time, lay off workers, reduce the workforce, are implemented with different and varying justifications throughout the years. And what that tells us is that each one of these justifications is disingenuous, because it's the same policy again and again. And it's, you know, for all kinds of reasons over the years. And that tells us that this is not the real reason they want to lay off workers. The real reason that Harvard wants to lay off workers is that it thinks like a profit-making corporation. It has a fundamentally antagonistic attitude towards its workers. It doesn't view its workers as part of a community. And I think that is another huge shame. And I think not only is it shameful, it's also completely incorrect, because if I think back to my time at Harvard and I look around here at the faces here, I see many people here who are workers at Harvard who were very important in my own, you know, not only personal development, but also intellectual development, who were far more important in my intellectual development and the intellectual interactions I had with them than many of the faculty here in the department. And I think it's very important, you know, for us to keep this in mind. That workers are a very important part of the community. They are as important as the students and the faculty of this university, and Harvard needs to understand this. Yeah. You know, at the other end of the spectrum, and just to drive this point home, I was looking through these figures again, and I looked at the figures of the people who are the top paid people at Harvard. You know, these are the members of this Harvard management company. And the latest figures, which are the figures they released last year, say that the top five people here were paid $28 million in the fiscal year 2009-2010. Now they say they need this number, you know, they need to pay people $28 million, which can support hundreds of workers. They need to pay this number for performance, you know, because these guys are so talented. But the funny thing is that this included, you know, these figures are for the year 2009, when the endowment returned minus 27%. So, you know, these guys had a performance of minus 27% and they got paid $28 million. And I think this is indicative of the attitude that Harvard has, which is that there are some people who deserve to be treated with kid gloves, who deserve to be paid, you know, lots and lots of money, and there are other people who are redundant. And I think this is something that really needs to change. And I think that the people here, you know, including the students and everyone, it's very important that we have succeeded in the past, and it's really important for us to succeed. I just want to end with a few comments. You know, I was looking through these letters that the president and the provost wrote about library reorganization. But I want to point out that, you know, there are several things that Harvard can do to progressively reorganize its libraries. For example, it's very important that the libraries not be an elitist collection, that they be open not only to scholars in the university, but to scholars around the world and to members of the community in this place. But that is not something that Harvard wants to do. And I think this is something that if Harvard decided to do would, you know, require experienced library workers, but this is not something that Harvard wants to do. They talk about budgets, but one of the major aspects of the budgets here, even though it's a small fraction of Harvard's running budget, you know, goes into the acquisition of journals. Now, journals are things that the scientific community, at least, has been realizing over the past few years are basically redundant. If you look at the field that I work in, you know, almost everything that we do is now completely open access. And Harvard could try and take the initiative towards bringing these kinds of progressive changes in other fields. You know, it could take the initiative to move towards open access work, but that is not something that it wants to do. Because the attitude that it has towards information is this corporate attitude where it wants to hoard and restrict information, get rid of workers, and that's something that's not only detrimental to the workers, but also detrimental to the Harvard libraries itself in the long term. And so I think it's really important that all of us here send a message to the management that they need to, you know, work, and it is true they need to modernize the libraries, but this has to happen hand in hand with the workers and with the community of this university. And if they take a corporate attitude, that not only damages lives, but also damages their own systems.